Can you stay up for the weekend and blame God for looking too old? Can you find all that you stand?
What's up, guys? It's Cameron Fous with FousAlerts.com. It is April 25th. Just want to go over the top breakout plays that are in play right now based off the Fous 4 trading system. First up is CYTK. This is in what I like to call a revival pattern, and this is probably my top stock pick at the moment right now. We've tried to trade this several times on the breakout beginning at 115, and this thing got real choppy right in this little section right here, but we are back to the breakout zone here. So basically, for me, as long as this thing can ride the 13 EMA, which is indicated by this yellow line here, that's basically what I use to indicate where the short-term trend is. So as long as a stock is continuing to trend along the 13 EMA following one of my breakout patterns, there's really no telling how high it can go. And as you can see, CYTK here is in a long-term breakout. Go to the weekly chart. This is finally breaking out this neckline that's been forming up here in the 120s section. So we got a lot of resistance that's beginning to break. We have a huge volume interest here, and plenty of upside. There's really just kind of a downtrend here. Why I call it a revival pattern is basically this lead-in trend is bearish. You can see the stock has just been getting beat down. Then finally, form up a triangle breakout pattern here, and we have a lot of buying interest here, as you can see by the huge volume is increases. So it's basically reviving itself, hence why I call this pattern the Fous 4 revival pattern. It's one of my favorite patterns to play. It's definitely one of the most common, and some of these stocks can see huge returns. The latest one, just to show you an example of one that actually did rip off after a revival breakout that we did play, was GST. Check out the same exact kind of pattern. The lead-in trend here was bearish, and we got this nice, beautiful looking breakout pattern. I actually got long at 150 or 140, and I ended up selling up here for profits, making a nice quick gain in about just one day there. So made a great profit there, but sometimes you can't just get caught up in that one big day, and you got to let it ride the trend. As you can see here, the 13 EMA still never got broke down until about 2:42 or so. So this one basically ran up a whole dollar all the way up to 3 before finally breaking down at about 2:40, but it's still kind of bounced off that level, and now it's back up to 2:77. So GST, this is a great example of a Fous 4 revival pattern that we did play, just didn't take full advantage of the actual major long-term swing. But looking at CYTK, this is just the beginning of it. We just broke out, we're coming back and retesting support. I actually longed again at 127 yesterday. Right now I have close to 30,000 shares at 127 in CYTK. My long-term profit is $2 per share, but if we can get a spike above these recent highs and get a nice candle on strong volume there, I would consider definitely taking partial profit just to ensure that I have some gains. But this is probably my favorite play as of right now, CYTK breaking out of a revival pattern. Up next is a new one, IFMI. This is what basically I call this kind of a force pattern. You can see the lead-in trend is neutral. Then all of a sudden we got this huge run up on volume. As you can see here, broke out a triangle pattern here. Get a line here, and also breaking above $3 per share. And that's a whole number. Whole number resistance, or whole numbers typically act as an area of support and resistance. And when those areas break out, that could definitely mean the beginning of a next leg up. As you can see, yesterday we actually had a false breakout above $3 per share, but today we actually got a strong close at 320. I actually longed this stock today. It's still riding the 13 EMA as of right now, so as long as this kind of holds the $3 per share level, and the 13 EMA, this can definitely run much higher. This is the most closely related position or trade that I could show you of this was a recent trade, was HGSH. Let's pull this chart up here. This is one same exact pattern. As you can see here, the lead-in trend, let's pull this back so we can see what's going on. This was the breakout here on HGSH. I actually got long at 450. As you can see, the lead-in trend is kind of just neutral. Then all of a sudden, it had this large spike in volume and broke out of this triangle pattern and also started getting back above $4 per share finally. Had a nice little spike in volume. From here, I held it for a little bit, and then I ended up selling at 5 and made about 2,300 bucks very, very quickly. And then this thing just continued to explode, and now it's up at 1246 from 450. I didn't take full advantage of this chart, unfortunately. But, you know, as long as they hold the 13 EMA following one of these breakout patterns, there's really no telling how high it could go. But it's just, you know, it's hard to try to ride the trend sometimes. And once I see, you know, $2,000-$3,000 in profits, I'm like, I want to make that money. I take it and I just move on. Unfortunately, I miss out on some of these huge runs here because I'm too impatient. But, you know, again, I can't, you know, repeat myself enough. As soon as it breaks out of a Fous 4 pattern, as long as it continues to hold the 13 EMA, you know, these things continue to double and triple within just weeks. So that's HGSH. This is the force pattern. The latest force pattern I'm in now is IFMI, which is just breaking out today. Just broke above that $3 hold number resistance. So I definitely have, you know, a lot of confidence in IFMI being able to continue to break out here. Next up is MELA. This is a small health stock. This just broke out here today. Got a nice increase in volume. You know, it hasn't gotten that big breakout yet. It got volume in today, but we're hitting resistance right at the 50-day moving average, and we're at, and also at the resistance of these past two spikes. So up here at 125, and this spiked out at 127 and 127. So basically, we need to get above these highs. Today's high was 126, and also we basically pretty much hit the 50-day moving average, so that's also acting as resistance. But if we can break out above that level, I definitely think that we can see a continued momentum push here on IFM or MELA. As you can see, this is a revival pattern as well. Long-term bearish trend coming in here, and we're finally kind of starting to turn around after we based out near a dollar. So if we can break out above this 127 level, which is also right here at the 50-day moving average, that could trigger a huge short squeeze and getting a lot of buyers in. So MELA, I'm also in this position, looking forward to seeing if we can make some money on this trade as well. Another one is REFR. This is a very low flow stock. As you can see here, some of these days this thing just absolutely blows up. This day it started out at 363, went all the way as high as 491. So this stock can definitely make moves. And as you can see, it's continuing to ride the 13 EMA here. It still has not broken it down. So basically what I'm looking for here on REFR is for all of a sudden another large spike off the support level and potentially break out of this triangle pattern here. And see if we can get another large spike up. If we can break out above this triangle, I definitely think that we're going to see another huge volume rip and potentially run back up towards $5 per share. But if we continue to, you know, go sideways and we start breaking down the 13 EMA here, I'll definitely get out of this position and cut my loss. But anyways, that's about it for today's breakouts. These are my favorite breakout plays that are based off of my strategy, the Fous 4 system. Also, come check out FousAlerts.com if you want my real-time buy and sell alerts.